Problem number 3. After giving a discount of 20%, a sari is sold for ₹1120. Find the mark price of the sari given. Percentage of discount is equal to 20%. Selling price is equal to ₹1120. Mark price we have to find. Now, my dear student, discount is always given on mark price, and therefore mark price is not given, so we cannot apply the formula, but we can find it by ratio. So we will consider the ratio of, we'll consider mark price and selling price. If mark price is 100 rupees, 20% discount, 100 minus 20 means selling price will be 80 rupees. Mark price is given, mark price we have to find. So mark price will be X, but the selling price is given 1120. We can have a cross multiplication. ATX is equal to 1120 into 100. X is equal to 1120 into 100 upon 81. Cancel. X is equal to 1120 into 10 upon 8. X is equal to 11200 upon 8. Let's divide it. Therefore, X is equal to 11200 divided by 8. 8 ones are 8. 9, 10, 11. 3 left. We'll bring 2 as it is now. 8 4 the 32 minus 00 2 0 left will put 2 0 here. So, x is equal to 1 4 0 0 rupees. But what is x? Mark price is equal to 1400 rupees. Answer. The mark price of sari is 1400 rupees. We'll see the next problem. Problem number 4. Problem number 4. Very interesting problem, my dear student. A shopkeeper decides to sell a certain item at a certain price. Here, the shopkeeper decides to sell an an item
to a certain
price.
We'll take this first information. Let the let his decided price be
100.
He marks the price of the item by increasing the decided price by
30.
So 30% of decided price. So 30% of decided PRS price, we have to calculate. 30% means 30 upon 100, of means into, and decided price is what? 100. So 30% of decided price is 30.
30 rupees.
He marks the price of the item by increasing the decided price by 30%. Let his decided price be 100 rupees. 30% of decided price, we have to find out. 30% decided price is 100 rupees. So 30% of 100 is 35. So this 30 we have to put in 100. Then what will happen? We will get the mark price. So mark price is equal to decided price plus 30% of decided price. So mark price, so mark price is equal to mark price is equal to decided price is 100, 10% to decided price is 30. So mark price is equal to 130 rupees. Now let he decide the price to be 100. First point, he increase it by 30% on the decided price, that is what, 30 rupees. Mark price is equal to decided price plus 30% upon decided price. So mark price will be 130 rupees. Then what does he say? While selling the item, he offered 20% discount. Discount is equal to 20% of mark price. Third, while selling the item, he offers 20% discount. So discount is equal to 20% on the mark price. 20 by 100 of means multiplication 130. This is what? Discount 0, 0,
10 1 the 10, 10 2 the 30. Discount is equal to 13 into 2, 2 3 the 6, 2 1 the 2. So discount will be 26 rupees. Now we'll find the selling price. Selling price is equal to mark price minus discount. Selling price is equal to mark price is what? 130. Discount is what? 26. So selling price is equal to 104 rupees. ₹104. Now, he had decided the price of item to be 100. Rupees and he sold it for 104 rupees. Here he got 4 rupees more than the decided price, which is equal to 4%. Therefore, he gets 4 rupees more means 4% more. On the decided price. We'll see the next problem. Problem number 5. Let us first understand the problem. On a certain item, a shopkeeper gives 8% discount. What is given? Discount 8%. Percentage of discount is equal to 8%. Second, and still he gets 15% profit if the market price is rupees 1750. Mark price is equal to 1750. What is the cost of the item for the shopkeeper? We have to find cost price. But in order to find cost price, we also have to find discount. Now, here percentage of discount and mark price is given. Therefore, let the discount be X. Then according to formula, method 1, 8% of 100 is equal to discount upon mark price. 8/100 is equal to discount is X and mark price is 1750. We'll have the cross multiplication. 100x is equal to 1750 into 8. X is equal to 1750 into 8 upon 100. 0, 0 cut. 2 4 the 2 5 the 10. X is equal to 175 into 4/5. Let's divide 175 by 5 5 3 the 15. Minus 15, 16, 17, 2, 5 will come down, 5, 5 the 25, 0, 0. So, 5, 1 the 5, 5, 35 the 1, 75.
5. X is equal to 35 into 4. See, 35 plus 35, 70. 70 plus 70, 140. X is equal to 140 rupees. Discount is equal to 140 rupees. Method second. Discount is equal to 8% of my price. 8 upon 100 into my price is 1750. Discount. Now, discount is equal to 0, 0 cut, 2 4 za 2, 5 za 10. Discount is equal to 4 by 5 into 175. Again, 175 divided by 5, 5, 3 is 15, 16, 72, 5 will come down, 5, 5 is 25, 0, 0. So, 5, 1 is 5, 5, 35. 175. Discount is equal to 4 into 35. Discount is equal to 35 plus 35, 70. 70 plus 70, 140 rupees. So, 140 rupees is the discount. Here, by both the methods, we have calculated the discount. Now, he got 15% profit. Profit. Therefore, cost price therefore, we will calculate now selling price. Selling price is equal to mark price minus discount. Selling price is equal to mark price is 1750 and discount is 140 rupees. Selling price is equal to 1750 minus 041. 0 minus 0, 0, 5 minus 4, 1, 7 minus 1, 6, 1 will come as it is.
So selling price is 1610 rupees. Now we got 15% of profit. So let us have a cost price. Selling price. If we decide the cost price to be 100 rupees, then selling price 15% more, because 15% is the profit is 115, and if the selling price is 1610, cost price will be X. Cross multiplication. X is equal to 1610 into 100. 115x is equal to 1610 into 100 means 2 zero I put more. X is equal to 161000 upon 115. Let's divide it. One six one zero 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 divided by 115. 115 one the 115 minus. This will become 11. This will become 5. 11 minus 5. 5 plus 5 10, 10 plus 1 11. 6. 5 minus 1 4. 1 minus 1 0. 1 0 I will bring down. One five into four. 4 5 are 20, 0, 2 carry. 4 1 are 4, 5, 6. 4 1 are 4. So 115 into 4, we get 460 minus 0, 0. Two zeros are left. I will take it up. 0, 0. So X is equal to 1400 rupees. But what is X? cost price is equal to 1400 rupees. Answer. We'll see the next problem.